All right, what's going on, guys? Geiger's Gaming here. Today, we are back with another video. This is my 10K special video. I know I have 11K at the moment, but I don't know. I was lazy and I didn't make the video until now. So yeah, we're just gonna get right into it. So this is my 10K special Q&A video. So you guys asked me questions in my last Forza video, and I'm gonna respond to them. So let's get into it. Shaman Jirachi, I'm not sure if I pronounced that right, I'm so sorry if I butchered your name or not, but this person asks, what's your favorite Japanese car and American car? Well, obviously my favorite Japanese car has to be the GTR R34 Skyline, because that's just bae. And my American car, I don't really have that many. I think it'll probably have to be the Dodge Challenger, the 2015 SRT version. Yeah, that's pretty much, I guess. I mean, I'm not really into American cars as much as I am to, like, Japanese and, like, pretty much, like, any foreign kind of vehicle. So, yeah, let's go into the next question. The Lost Soul asks, how did you come up with your name, Guy Goes Gaming? It's actually not that interesting. So basically, I knew I wanted a channel, like, by 2014. I just didn't know what kind of name I wanted, so I basically just went to Facebook and I just asked, like, my friends. I just posted a status. I'm like, hey guys, I'm gonna start a YouTube channel. What should my name be? And I don't know. There was a bunch of lists of names popped up. I didn't really like them until one of my friends recommended Guy Goes Gaming. And I was like, oh, this is neat. It has my name in it and has gaming, so it kind of like shows like what I post and stuff. So this is really good. I used it, and it kind of stuck ever since, because, you know, I just really like it. And people seem to, like, I don't know, the people seem to remember it, just they can't seem to spell it, so that's the downside to it, but everything else is fine, perfectly A-okay with it. So, yeah, that's pretty much how I got my name, just posting a Facebook status. let's go to the next one. So, Nico asks, do you go to school with Jack, and what's your first Forza game? No, I don't go to school, Jack. I don't live anywhere near him. And what's my favorite Forza? What's my first Forza game? It was actually recent. It was Forza Horizon 2 on the Xbox One. I believe I saw T Martin play it, and I, like, at this point I got, like, really into, like, cars and stuff, so I decided to buy it. And I actually like really enjoyed it. I just didn't have friends to play with. That was a problem. That's why I really stopped playing it for a while. And then, yeah, that's pretty much it. My first Forza game was Forza Horizon 2. Okay, Rigid Nick Gaming asks, Q&A, if you had unlimited money, name 10 cars you would buy. I gotta think about this one. 10 cars, that's a lot. That's actually a lot. Okay, let's, obviously the, Skyline R34 GTR, because that's bae. Probably the 2017 GTR as well. I say the 98 Toyota Supra. That sounds pretty cool to have, along with the 2016 Audi R8, the V10 Plus. I don't know. What was that? Like four? Yeah, it was four. The McLaren 650S Coupe, or just Coupe. McLaren P1. That's a nice one to have too. That'll be a nice one to have at least. Think of anything else. The Bugatti Chiron, that would be dope. That would be really cool. Pagani Huayra, I think that would be pretty dope to have. Pretty much this entire list of cars I'm naming is pretty much just like foreign vehicles, mostly at least. I think the next one would be a Ferrari 458 Italia. And what was that, 9? Yeah, I think my last one would be the Jaguar F-Type R Coupe, I think that's what it's called, something like that. But yeah, that should be 10. If I missed one, I'm sorry, but yeah, that's what I'll have. So yeah, next question. Okay, so Jashwan James asks, what made you start YouTube? And it's not really an interesting story to it. I just saw like a lot of YouTubers like actually enjoying playing video games and stuff, and I thought it was pretty cool. The person I watched a lot a while back was this guy called The Gaming Lemon. You guys probably heard of him. He's was like 3 million, I think. 3, 4 million. Something like that. He doesn't post as much anymore. But that's probably just, I don't know why, actually. I don't know what I was about to say. But yeah, he used to post like a lot of funny like solo content, and that's why I kind of wanted to base my channel off of solo content. But I don't know, I kind of realized I'm not as funny as I thought I would be if I started a channel up, just, you know, me like making jokes and being funny on random games and stuff. But yeah, he's pretty much the reason why I started YouTube, and yeah, it kind of just grew from there. The next question by the Cotters, he asks, or they ask, or whoever asks, what was your first video game? And kind of think back, it's been a while. I don't know, can't remember. I think it was either I think it was just Mario Kart on the N64, or I think it was Mario Party, one of those games. But yeah, those are the games that I first ever played when I remember. I probably played a lot more, but those are the games I remember from my childhood. I wish I could still play them, but I don't think I have the N64 anymore, so that's bad, but whatever. It's not a big deal. But yeah, I think that was my first video game I've ever played. So the next question slash comment comes from Stan Comms Videos. They say or slash ask. First of all, I predicted that you'll get from 5k to 10k in no time. And now my question is, will you keep replying to your subscribers even if you hit 100k? Okay, so if you guys haven't caught on by now, you probably should, because yeah. But I like to reply to my subscribers in my comment section below. Well, I don't know why I said below, but in my comment section, because, you know, I like to keep in touch with them, kind of make things more interactive with more, like, I guess, I wouldn't say personal, but like just more, I guess that's like the only word I could actually use, but like more personal with my fans. So they like, I don't know, I guess they kind of won't forget me in a way. It's not like they would, but like, I feel like if I don't reply to them, we won't have that like same connection if I did reply to them. So now getting to the question is, if I would reply even if I hit 100k, it really depends, because like obviously, like most YouTubers, I feel like they reply to some comments when the video first comes up. But besides that, I really don't think it would happen as much as I do right now. Because, you know, I probably have like a bigger comment section if I ever do hit 100k. Because like right now I'm averaging about like 50 to 100 comments every video. And like, it's not a big deal. I mean, there's some comments I don't reply to, but most of them I do. So yeah. So if I don't reply to you at 100k, well, you gotta understand that, well, if I do ever get to 100k, you gotta understand that, well, I probably won't be able to, because I just won't have that much time in my hands as I do right now. So, yeah, the next question. XGus17 asks, what's your favorite video game? Well, if we're talking Xbox terms, it'd probably have to be Forza Horizon 3, because that's where my channel is mostly based on now, because it's, like, growing, and I'm actually enjoying it and stuff, so that's a plus. But, I think my favorite game overall would have to be Uncharted. Like, I never played Uncharted 4 because I don't have a PS4, and I want to get one so I can play like those exclusive games that I really want to play, like The Last of Us and the and Uncharted 4. But from like the gameplay I've seen and stuff from the game, oh my god, that game looks gorgeous and stuff. So it just that seems like I would enjoy that the most if I ever get to play that. So yeah. That's my favorite video game. So the next question, Chelsea Adaman asks, what is your dream job and car? I can tell you right now, my favorite car is, when you heard this like multiple times already, the R34 Skyline GTR, because that's just freaking beautiful. And my dream job, I don't know, like something that has to do with like the entertainment industry. I don't know, I think anything would be fine, but I don't really have anything like certain for a dream job. That's just pretty much like the vaguest answer I could give. Just anything in the entertainment industry. Okay, the next question. Renee E.K. He asks, what car do you drive? And he says also, congrats on 10K, man. Appreciate it. Thanks, man. Appreciate it a lot. So, yeah. So what car do I drive? I drive a Infiniti G37X. That's, yeah, nothing to it. I think I'll just put a picture up on the screen of what it looks like. If, yeah. So, yeah. Next question. Jordy Pluto asks, if you did not do YouTube, what would you do? There should be a comment between doing this, not to sound like a grammar Nazi, but that's, yeah. Okay, do this for the Q&A. If YouTube, okay, what would I do if I did not do YouTube? I don't know. I'd probably do a lot more school stuff, honestly, because I'm still in school. So, yeah. I don't know. Honestly, I think I'll just be... I'll probably just do more stuff in school, be more, like, productive. Well, not productive, because like, I am productive at school. But, I don't know. I'll probably, like, just not have to worry about more things that I have to do outside of school and stuff. I could probably, like... rest a lot more. I really don't know what I would do besides YouTube. Probably try to make my way up in the entertainment industry. Just like trying to do stuff for that. But yeah, that's pretty much all I could give you. Sorry if that didn't really fit your needs of... Yeah. Okay, so next question. Okay, Braxton Davis asks, what is your favorite Forza Horizon 3 car? I don't really think I have a favorite car in that game. I usually just drive a bunch of random stuff. I say the car I drive the most would probably have to be any... I think any, like, year of the GTR. Let's be honest here. Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, I drive it, like, any year of, like, the GTR. That's basically it, yeah. Okay, so, next question. Ritvik Aurora, he asks, or she asks, or whatever, favorite hypercar, favorite muscle car, favorite car in general. Also, congrats on 10,000 subscribers. Thanks, man. My favorite hypercar probably have to be the McLaren P1. That looks dope, looks sexy, looks beautiful, everything. Favorite muscle car, I think going back to that American... what's my favorite American car question? It would probably, yeah, it would definitely have to be the Dodge Challenger 2015 version. And the favorite car in general, GTR, obviously. A lot of these, like, car questions, like, favorite car questions are probably just related to the GTR. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, the next question. Reed Donor asks, what is your favorite game and console? Okay, my... the favorite game will have to be Uncharted, and favorite console, it would probably have to be, definitely the GameCube. GameCube, definitely. I think I have the most memories on the GameCube than I do Xbox, PlayStation, or, like, the N64. The GameCube had, like, I think it had, like, way too many games. I started playing Lego games. I played the Mario Super Smash Bros. A lot. There's another game, I forgot what it was called, but I used to play like a bunch of games on the GameCube, so I think that would have to be probably my favorite console. Next question. What other games will you play on your channel? This is asked by Mula Games. I mean, I'm down to play whatever on my channel, honestly. It's just pretty much based on what you guys actually want to see, because like I... you guys probably know this. I post Modern Warfare Remastered campaign videos like every week. And like, it's not I really care for the views. It just kind of like the views pretty much tell me like who's watching it, and like not a lot of you guys are watching it. So I kind of like, that's why I don't really post that many different games. Because if you look at the Forza videos compared to the Call of Duty videos, like there's a wide range of different views than it actually should be. But yeah, like I'm down to really post anything, but you guys really just got to give me feedback if you guys actually like this or not. But the reason why I'm still posting the Call of Duty videos is because I kind of made like a promise to myself that I would actually finish like a full series on my channel, because like yeah, we had a YouTuber's life. I think we're only like on episode 5, and I just kind of stopped. And there's something else, but yeah, that's pretty much the reason why I don't post anything else. But I'm totally am down to post whatever. You just guys got to hit me up and let me know in the comment section below. So, yeah. Next question is from Fo Ra, and he has multiple questions. What is your favorite car? GTR. What's your favorite game that you like most besides FH3? I think I'm gonna go back to Xbox games now exclusively that I play, not like games outside of Xbox. So I think the game I like the most probably have to be GTA, because like I mean I still play it, not as much as I used to though, but yeah, I enjoy GTA a lot, and there's gonna be like a new update soon, I heard. So maybe you guys will see videos on that, hopefully. Are you gay? No. How old are you? 16. I'm gonna be 17 next month. Yeah. Next question. Ace Video Makers asks, are you planning or do you want to make this your career? I mean, I would like to make this like a fun job for me to have, because I've seen other YouTubers get paid numerous amounts of money from doing YouTube videos, and that's not the reason why I'm doing this. It's just like a fun hobby to do. But if I can possibly make this like a job in the future for myself, I would definitely be down. Cause just making videos for a living just sounds fun. Honestly, just playing games or like vlogging something or something like that, it just sounds like really entertaining. And plus, like, one of my role models, he always told like his fans to like follow his dream, or follow your dreams, and kind of just do what you love. And this is basically what I'm doing. I'm following my dreams and doing what I love. I like to make videos and stuff, entertain you guys, and that's basically what I like to be doing. So yeah, that's what I'm following, and I hope I can possibly make this a career for myself in the future. So yeah, next question. Thanks for the question, dude. I appreciate that one. Next question. Okay, this is a quick question. Callum Bristow, he asks, for the Q&A, how old are you, and at what age was you when you created your YouTube challenge? Well, I think that should be channel. 17, already, well, 16, but 17 in a month, like I said before. And what age did I create my YouTube channel? I'm assuming that's going to be channel, so if I mistake that, I'm sorry. I was 14, I believe. Yeah, I started this at October 14th, 2014, and yeah, I mean, can't really go on from that question from there. So yeah, I was 14 when I started. Okay, the next question is from Diane Granke. I'm sorry if I butchered your name. I don't know how to pronounce it. I'm sorry, but assuming that's supposed to be how. So how is your fair? Oh, how? What? I'm confused. Okay, the question is horribly written, but it's all right. So I think it's who is your favorite player in the Ultra Crew? Okay, well, I don't want to name favorites, because I think that'll just be unfair for everybody else who watches it. But I don't know. I think I share the same relationship with everybody equally. I think, at least, I don't know. I could be wrong. I could just be a complete scumbag and just like a certain person over the other person. I mean, it probably seems that way, and like probably some videos and like kind of off camera stuff, it kind of seems like I just don't appreciate other people, but like I definitely appreciate every single one of these people that I've met, and these guys are probably the best people I've ever met on Xbox. They're probably like, yeah, they're like the nicest people I've ever met. They're the weirdest people I've ever met. They're the strangest. It kind of diverses, but yeah, I can't really name a favorite person that I like in the Ultra Gamers Crew. So yeah. The next question is from Hydrus Hydro, and he would ask, would you play with fans? I am totally down to play with you guys, but the thing is, I am bad at setting up like certain things, because I feel like something will just go wrong, and I feel like it wouldn't last as long as I actually anticipated. So, I mean, I'm totally down. It's just I gotta think of like stuff to do, so that way it doesn't get too boring for you guys, and yeah, that's basically it. So I'd be totally down to play with fans whenever, but it really just depends on how I'm feeling or what I have set up for you guys. Okay, the next question is from Heatron Jr. And he asks, do you hate American cars? I wouldn't say I hate them. I don't really think I hate anything. I mean, that's probably a huge lie. I mean, I strongly dislike things. Let's say that. But do you hate American cars? I don't like them as much as I do like JDM vehicles and just any type of foreign vehicle. But I do appreciate some of them, like the Challenger or like any kind of like Dodge car, the Charger, Challenger, stuff like that. The Ford Focus, I like that. But anything else, like really, I don't really enjoy or like to look at. So I don't say I hate American cars, but I don't like them as much as I do other cars. Okay, next question is by Rosda Boss 54, and they ask, what's your dream car? PS, you and the entire crew are amazing YouTubers. Thank you very much, I appreciate that. And I'm assuming you guys are gonna say, I'm gonna say the GTR, but every single car question coming up after this, well, yeah, after this question is completely non-GTR related. I'm gonna switch my cars up. So I'll just name my second favorite car. My second favorite car, or my second favorite dream car, would probably have to be the Porsche Carrera. I think that's how it's pronounced. Porsche Carrera 918 or 918. Coupe? I don't know. I can't remember the name off the top of my head, but something like that. It's pretty much any Porsche. I would be down to have a Porsche in my life, because that sounds dank. But yeah, next question. Lego023 asks, who inspired you to make YouTube videos? And this goes back to like how I started my channel and stuff. This goes back to the Gaming Lemon. He kind of inspired me to do stuff like this. He makes me want to call it, kind of make videos and random games to kind of make them more entertaining than they actually are, and just kind of make anything honestly hilarious. But that didn't really happen because I'm more of a I don't know, I'm more of a people's person in a way
I've
that
never felt
I like
such
to
terror.
play with friends to make things entertaining for myself. Because if I whenever I'm playing by myself, it's really like it's fun, but it's also boring because like it's not entertaining in which that I'm not talking to anybody and that's just kind of boring. So yeah, again, the Gaming Lemon kind of just
Eternity
helped
has
me,
twice
or not
before
helped
sent
me, but
great
inspired me
plans
to
to
make my
prominence.
YouTube channel. Sir Bikes a
Twice
Lot,
before we have vanished.
us, if asks if you can have one supercar in real life, what would it be? Probably the that was a weird sound. Yeah, it would definitely have to be like, I think it would be cool if I had a Ferrari. A Ferrari would be sick. I'm down to have a Ferrari. Like the what was that one I
This
named on the
is
top 10 list I
not
would have for
very
five
long.
unlimited money?
Has elements of
The five no, 458. It was a 458. Yeah, the 458 Italia. I would be down to have that for my supercar I have in real life, unless it's considered a sports car. I don't know. But yeah, next question. Okay, Pragmatic Wisdom. They ask, how long have you been gaming for, and what is your favorite genre of games? I like this question. I think, I don't know. I can't remember how long I've been gaming for. It's been a while. I know that for a fact. I think like between the age of 5 and 10, I believe so. Sometime around there. That was when I started playing the N64 and stuff, and that was when I had a lot of fun when I was a child. But you call it. And what is your favorite genre of games? I like adventure games, car games, especially considering the fact that my channel is kind of based around that. So yeah, car games, adventure games. I think just kind of like first-person shooter games, like Call of Duty or like Battlefield. Yeah, but I think I would mostly like enjoy a lot of like adventure games like Uncharted or Tomb Raider or Just Cause. Those are really fun. So yeah. Thanks for the question, dude. I like that. Okay, next question. Churbro, they ask, what are your plans for the future on YouTube and more Forza or new games? So this kind of relates back to another question. I'm down to play whatever, honestly. You guys just have to recommend it. And if I have the game or if I want to buy it, then I'll be down to post it. It really just depends on you guys if you guys actually enjoy it. I mean, it also depends if what you call it, if I actually just really want to make a video on this, no matter how bad the views get or something, I'll probably just still post it because that's what I enjoy, and that's kind of why I've done this, why I do this, because it's stuff that I like to do. And yeah, so future plans, nothing's really changing. Well, obviously we're gonna like back when September comes up again, we're gonna get Forza Motorsport 7, if that's gonna be a thing. Hopefully that's a thing. But that's probably gonna come out. Hopefully it does, and that's probably gonna add more Forza to our channel and stuff, or to my channel at least. So yeah, thanks for the question, dude. Next question. Manuel XG asks, how did you get into cars? I got into cars, I think, like, okay, this is probably not the best way to get into cars, but I started watching, yeah, Fast and Furious, and, like, that's when I kind of really got into cars. And, just same, God, I can't remember, what was my first movie? I think it was Too Fast, Too Furious is the first one I watched, and then I kind of, like, skipped around. I got Too Fast, Too Furious, and then kind of stopped watching the series for a while, and then 2013 rolled around and Fast and Furious 6 came out. Then I kind of just started from the first one to the sixth one, and I kind of watched those like a lot. And then then Furious 7 came out, and yeah, just those movies really got me into like cars and stuff. That's why the R34 GTR is probably my favorite freaking cars in the world, because it's gorgeous. And plus, it's like, the bad part is it is like freaking illegal in America to actually drive it and stuff, so that's the bad part. But I heard they were like making it illegal in like many years, so hopefully by then I could buy it. Most likely not, but yeah, thanks for the question, dude. Okay, the last question is gonna be the most anticipated question of all time in this comment section. I swear to God, I had like the most questions like related to the same topic. It's stupid, but yeah. Basically, how did I meet Jack and how I joined the Ultra Gamers crew? So, basically, I don't know the full story, because I don't know Jack's point of view or, like, the crew's point of view before I joined. So, yeah, you're probably going to, like, miss out on a few little details, but I'll just tell you guys my point of view. So, I found Jack's channel, I think, around where he had, like, 50 to 80,000 subscribers, around that. Stage or phase or whatever it is, around that time, and that's when I started like watching his videos. And as one of his GTA 5 videos like were like, you know, really entertaining, and I liked it, so I'm like, oh, I'm gonna subscribe to this guy. So just months go by, I watch his videos, I join his live streams, I join a few live streams that made it into a video. So yeah, that was cool to see myself in a video. But I think, yeah, one day, the entire crew was on. I think it was like a Saturday or Sunday. The whole crew was on, and they were, I think they were playing GTA 5. And I was just chilling, playing by myself, because I don't have a lot of friends on Xbox at the time. And so I was just kind of driving around in my car and stuff. And I see an invite from Who's Nasty Fox. And I was like, on my inside, I was like, holy shit. And I was just kind of freaking out in the inside. But then, like, he invited me to his game. I joined the game immediately, like any other person would, honestly. So I joined the game immediately. It was, I got into his car, and we were kind of just chilling in his garage, driving around the city and stuff. And there was, like, a certain moment where he stopped. I was like, okay, he's probably just doing something. And then I see that he invited me to a party, and I was like, oh my god. My enthusiasm kind of just like bumped up to a freaking 100%, and I was like screaming on the inside. I joined their party. Everybody was in there: Jack, Captain Alex, Slendy, I think Superburger, okay, Muddy, Pigeon, and Nasty, obviously. And we kind of just started playing from there. Like, they invited me, they were just talking to me and stuff. Like, I was being really chill with them and stuff, I guess you would say. And well, we kind of just hung out all day. And there was a time, like, around, like, late at night where they were kind of, like, talking about stuff that was happening inside of a group chat they have. And, well, I was kind of just sitting there, like, being quiet and stuff and, like, not doing anything because I couldn't say anything because, well, I wasn't a part of, like, the chat, so I couldn't, like, talk to them and stuff. So I couldn't relate to whatever they were talking about. So I was just kind of sitting there in silence, and, like, I think, I don't know, one of them just, like, suggested, like, hey, we should just get Gaigos in here. Because, like, I don't know, because I was kind of, like, out of it and stuff. So they invited me into the chat, and I think that's, like, the official, like, invitation to the crew, basically. Because I was never actually, like, officially invited to the crew. I was so I was invited to that group chat, and like no one ever said like, "Hey guy, guess you're in the crew." I was kind of just sitting there in the chat, just talking to them, and that was actually like a couple weeks that went by when I actually realized, "Hey, I might be in the crew," because like people talked about how people join the group chat, and people say like, "Oh, whoever joins the group chat, basically they are in the crew." I'm just like, "Oh, this is neat, this is cool." So yeah, that kind of stuck there, and yeah, that's where I am today, in the Ultra Gamers crew. Yeah, that's basically it. So hope you guys enjoy this Q&A. Hope you guys had your questions in the video. If they didn't make it to the video, then I'm sorry. There's probably just too many questions to be asked. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And yeah, peace out, everybody.